You are now entering the Queen Up Chronicles Talk Zone, the place where crowns are corrected, kings are supported, and the love is real.
Hold up, Jay.
Queen Up!
We're moving, we're grooving, we're building, we're loving. Great day, beautiful people. I am Jay West, and this is Queen Up Chronicles Talk. We look a little different because we're doing things a little bit different this season. We are taking advantage of modern technology, and we're hosting the interviews via Zoom. So I can be in the comfort of my home, and the guests can be in the comfort of their home as well. And it just makes sense to utilize what we have at hand. So next coming up, I have a guest. Her name is Reberca David. She is a certified public accountant. So it's some amazing information, and she's going to make a big announcement. So stay tuned. This is Queen Up Chronicles Talk, and I am Jay West.
Queen Up!
Queens, straighten your crowns. Kings, stand up! Queen Up Chronicles Talk.
Welcome back to Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West. And as I mentioned before, I have an amazing guest here. Her name is Reberca, and she is a certified public accountant. So welcome, Reberca. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm so happy to be here.
And you are a certified public accountant, correct?
Yes, that is correct.
What motivated you to become, because I have a lot of younger viewers, and I want them to understand what motivated you to become a certified public accountant.
Okay, so to be completely honest, as you can see right now, I do have on a FAU marketing shirt. So I originally went to school for marketing, and I kind of fell in the role of accounting. Okay. So it wasn't planned. I literally just fell there, and it just been working out ever since.
Oh, wow. Okay.
No, I was working for a CPA firm in Boca, and I really loved them. They were like family. You know how to say it, but
right.
They were like family, and they actually motivated me to become a CPA. So okay. I actually really like numbers, and I liked what I do. Okay. And honestly, my number one motivation was the fact that, so I'm from a small town of Belgrade. I don't know if anyone has ever heard of Belgrade.
Girl, absolutely. But girl, listen, I have family in Belgrade. We might be related, sis.
I'm Haitian, so are you Haitian?
Because we might be. I'm American. But honey, we're all related and connected at some point. Okay.
You're right. But first of all, in Belgrade, like, go to Belgrade and point out one CPA you can, because there's really no real accountants or CPAs in Belgrade.
Okay.
And also, there's so much fraud, like, around taxes and accounting going on, to the point where my mom and my brother were a victim. And so to be able to help them fix their problems, and knowing that there's many other people out there who need my help, that was probably my number one motivation.
Okay, wonderful. So initially you had a company that you worked for, and those people were kind of influential in you getting or becoming interested in becoming an accountant, right? And then now you're further motivated by the fraud that your mother and your brother have been subjected to.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, so, and again, you have to be a lover of numbers.
I want to say you have to be at least some kind of good with numbers. Maybe not a lover of numbers, but good with numbers.
You're really good and really accurate. That's important.
But exactly.
Listen, Reberca, so how long have you been an accountant?
I've been an accountant for 7 years now, ever since 2016. Yeah, that's 7 years. And I got my CPA license in 2020.
Okay. So would you encourage young women to go into that field?
I definitely would. I actually read an article last year saying that the accounting industry is actually looking for more people, because when you think of accountants, what do you think of? You think of old people, right?
Right.
Like you think of much older people. Mm-hmm. And a large percentage, of accountants are actually retiring because they're boomers.
And oh, wow. Right.
So, yeah, I would definitely recommend.
You know, so then now you have to have that succession plan in place for the newer accountants and younger accountants to come in and take their place, right?
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you for that. And when we come back, I want to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, I want you to tell me the three major roles are the three major things that are important for a CPA as it relates to a business.
Okay.
Okay, when we come back. Okay. We're going to take a commercial break. All right?
Yes.
So, listen, this is Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West. We're going to take a quick commercial break, and I'm here with Reberca. So stay tuned.
Great day, queens. It is time to level up and place your crown in the upright position. And the best way to do that is to queen up. There's levels to this. After all, your level up is all about you. Order your hoodie today, and you see how amazing the CEO, Jay West, wears it. Just a style idea. Order today.
Welcome back to Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West, and I'm still here with Reberca David. She is a certified public accountant, so we're happy to have her. So, Reberca, before we left for commercial break, we talked about the three things. What are the three responsibilities that a CPA has to a business owner?
Okay, so I am going to talk about the three responsibilities I feel like I have to a business owner. Number one, their books, maintaining their books and making sure their books are correct and in order. Okay. You will not believe, or maybe you will, that some people do not take care of their books. They're great at what they do, right, but their numbers are all messed up.
And right.
Honestly, that can shut you down. So
right. That's important, keeping that tally on what you're doing in your business, right?
Exactly.
Some people, money is going.
Exactly. So some people are not keeping an eye on that. They're just like making up the numbers for taxes, whatever it is. It will definitely catch up with you in the long run. The short run, everything might look good, but in about two, three, four years,
yeah,
it'll all catch up to
right.
you.
It catches up eventually. It does.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's number one, the books and the financials. Okay. Number two, I would say filing. So the filing means filing of the tax return,
okay,
sales tax, payroll tax, whatever it is. Because when you don't file, that also catch up to you. The right. IRS or the Florida Department of Revenue, whatever it is, they charge you a bunch of penalties.
Wow.
And sometimes you owe more penalties than you owe taxes because you haven't been keeping up with all of
wow.
this.
Wow. So paying yes. taxes is very important because, like you said, that can ultimately close your business.
It definitely can, because what some people are not understanding is the IRS can seize your property. And so I've seen, when I used to work in Boca for another firm, mm-hmm. I've seen the IRS harass someone for $8, threaten to seize their property for
$8. Really?
Imagine your home being taken away because you owe the IRS
$8. $8?
How ridiculous.
Wow.
$8. How ridiculous.
That is ridiculous.
Exactly. Wow. So imagine you owing them thousands of dollars and they're taking your home, your cars, they're garnishing your wages.
Right.
It's a real thing, and some people don't take it seriously.
Yeah, that's major. That is major. And major problem, sounds like.
Wow, wow. It definitely is.
Okay, so that's number two. What's number three?
Number three would definitely be planning. But you know, now that I think about it, I think planning should have been number one, because planning is the most important thing.
Wow.
Simply because, you know, everybody nowadays wants to start a business or something, do some kind of side hustle, mm-hmm. whatever it is. Planning is definitely more important because, as you know, the more money you bring in, the more taxes you have to pay.
Right.
But
right.
if you plan ahead of time, you can figure out, okay, this is approximately how much money I would owe mm-hmm. to the government with how much money I made, okay. and figure out what can you do to mm-hmm. lower that tax liability.
Okay. Okay. Wow.
Yeah. A lot of people, they ask me, so they'll come to me, do their taxes in March. And okay. of course, you know, you plug all of the numbers in the software. Mm-hmm. You know, you make sure all of the tax credits and mm-hmm. deductions are taken.
Right.
And then they ask, oh, why do I have to pay so much money? Because you didn't plan. That's why your business made so-and-so amount of money. Oh, what can I do to lower that tax liability? Well, you can mm-hmm. go back in time and ask that question in like November, October, before
wow.
the year ended.
Right. And we're in March. That's too late.
Exactly. The year already ended. You're paying taxes on 2022 income.
Right.
We're in 2023.
Right.
It's not a lot you could do.
Exactly. Exactly. Oh, my goodness. Those are great tips, Reberca. So we got number one, planning, because we're going to put that back at number one.
Definitely.
Planning, right. Keeping your books in check. Basically, the what's coming in and what's going out. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And also filing your taxes.
Yes.
Okay. So those are the three points that are very important, or three responsibilities of a CPA that are very, very important to a business. Okay. And I heard some great news, girl. I heard you got something coming out, but we're going to make the announcement after the commercial break. All right.
So sounds
we're gonna take
good.
A quick commercial break, and we're going to share with you the information or the great news that Reberca has to announce. All right, stay tuned. This is Queen Up Chronicles Talk.
Be That Bitch, Being in Total Control of Herself, a nonfiction book that focuses on women taking charge, knowing who they are, and coming out on top. It's available on Amazon.
Welcome back to Queen of Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West. I'm here with Reberca David, and she has a great announcement to make. So I'm going to let her, and congratulations, sis. Go ahead and make your announcement, honey. What you got going?
So I have my book. I actually wrote this book the end of last year, and it's called Entrepreneurship 101. I don't know if you guys can see it clearly.
Oh, we can't see. Okay, right there. Perfect.
Yes.
Entrepreneurship 101.
So it's Entrepreneurship 101, the things your CPA wants you to know regarding your business. And so if you are someone who wanted, it's mainly for people who are starting their business. Okay. And don't know how to start, where to start, anything about accounting, anything about taxes.
Okay.
I talk a lot more about a lot more than just accounting and taxes. Mm-hmm. I also talk a little bit about marketing. Again, I have my degree in marketing.
Right.
Exactly. It's not my primary focus, but you know, I know a little something. And it just has so much information in here. It literally tells you how to get started, how to register your business. You know, some companies, you could go through other companies, they'll charge you hundreds of dollars, but or you could just go to SunBiz and do it yourself.
Right. Exactly.
And just pay the SunBiz fee.
Exactly.
It'll tell you about your team. It'll tell you the importance of having a CPA. It'll tell you the importance of having about marketing. It'll tell you the importance of having a legal team if your business entails.
If it needs the legal team, right. Okay. So basically, Reberca, your book is a how-to guide to get started for businesses, new businesses. Because, girl, you got some good information in there. I love it.
Yes. I'm glad.
Again on that.
Yes. I also have, just want to quickly mention, I also have a checklist that just, you know, to get started. Because everyone kind of needs a checklist. So it's a guide.
Okay.
And it also gives you, like, business resources, where to look for funding, things about loans, grants, all of that good stuff.
Okay, that is great stuff, girl. That is a good guide, honey. I may need to get that. I'll tell you right now. That is great information. So tell the viewers where they can purchase the book.
The book is available on Amazon. So that's the main and easiest way you could get it.
Okay.
But it's also available on different retailers. So you could get it. You could get an ebook. You could get it on Kindle, Apple Books. Barnes and Nobles, wherever you get books from, but Amazon is obviously
the main factor. So you can get the hard copy, paperback, and the ebook from Amazon.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Wonderful. Girl, I am so proud of you. I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
Very happy. So Reberca, I wish you much success on your book. Let it be a bestseller. Okay. Let's put it out there in the universe. Make
Thank
it a
you.
Bestseller and let it do what it do. Right. And
Thank
also,
you so much.
Tell people how we can follow you. How can we keep in contact with you and just watch your progress and watch you build?
So I am available on all social media platforms. You can find me on Instagram, R David Associates. You can find me on Facebook, R David and Associates.
Okay.
Like the official name.
Nice.
And on TikTok also R David Associates, the same as Instagram.
Okay.
I share a lot of helpful tax and accounting tips.
Okay.
On TikTok, so definitely check us out.
Okay, yes, young queen, I love it. Again, congratulations on everything. Thank you for taking the time out to talk with me, and I look forward to connecting with you at a later time.
Thank you, I look forward to it as well.
Are you a business owner and are unsure about how to maintain your books? Your accounting is all over the place? Look no further. Reberca David has answered the call. She has written a book, Entrepreneurship 101, the things your CPA wants you to know regarding your business. Be sure to follow her on Facebook, Reberca David, CPA.
Welcome Welcome back to Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West, and I'm here with Antonio. Antonio is the CEO of Brothers Bowties. Thank you, Antonio, for being here.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
Listen, the bow tie is a very unique and very bold accessory. When did you develop your love for bow ties?
My love for bow ties has always been since I was a child. Mm-hmm. Being brought up in the church, even though I'm Muslim now, but being brought up in the church, I always admired the men who wore bow ties because it was rare. You barely seen men who wore bow ties. Okay. But whenever you've seen someone come in church with a bow tie, it always stood out compared to everybody else with a tie. So right. That's where the love for it actually started from. And when I got older and started taking church a lot more serious, I started making my own bow ties, and I really fell in love with bow ties. Like, I knew for sure I only wanted to wear a bow tie.
So Antonio, why bow ties as opposed to the regular longer tie?
Okay, so the bow tie to me, it stands out totally different. I have this slogan that I say, the tie is for a businessman and the bow tie is for the CEO of the business.
Okay, all right, I hear that. Okay.
But another kind of sad part to it, dealing with the tie and the bow tie, is the history behind both of them. If you go back to 1800s, 1700s, when the European or the colonizers came to America, when we started setting up our government or having these galas or Congress meetings, everything like that, everybody wore a bow tie. And a tie had got popular in America by default, and it has a negative connotation to it. So the tie original name is called a cabot, which was popular in Ireland, I mean. And the Irish people wore it to war. So they used to wear a tie literally to go kill people. And then in America, of course, you know, we had our own civil war, but then we also had slavery. So what ended up happening was that with slavery, when they used to run out of thick rope, some of the Irishmen was part of the Klansmen or seven of the Klansmen, they would get thick fabric and their tie, as we call it, a tie.
Okay.
As a free suit, and they'll walk around in the community or parade the neighborhoods already with a free tie noot. Just like you see on some movies, they do it with ropes. They walk around with a free tie noot already. So the actual knot of a tie is a noot. So that's why I chose the bow tie over the tie, and that's why I recommend that men wear bow ties over ties. Now, I'm not going to force you. Of course, I can't force you to, but...
Right. But look at this. You just gave us an entire history lesson, Antonio. I'm so appreciative of that because I never knew that. So basically, the tie was used during the time of war, and it became like a weapon once they, like you said, they ran out of the rope. That's really sad.
Yep.
That's really sad. And now I have a whole nother outlook on ties.
Yeah. And trust me, when I learned about it, I was like, oh, no. I was wearing ties all my life, you know, like when I was a child. Like, so what I do now, whether or not, when I go shopping, sometimes I go shopping in the mall or stuff like that. If I see a tie that has a different fabric, that has a fabric that I like, I actually still buy the tie, but I cut it up and I turn it into a bow tie.
Oh, wow. Good deal. So you have that advantage because you have that creativity to go ahead and make your own bow tie. But listen, I want to give the viewers a little tutorial that you did to show them how to tie the bow tie, okay? So we're gonna take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we'll have more from Antonio. We're gonna call him Mr. Bowtie, all right? So stay tuned.
Okay, so you wanna put the bow tie around your neck. You wanna angle like this. One side is in the middle of the bow tie, and the other side is longer. You take the longer side, put it over the short side, bring the bow tie under. Take the short side and make a loop as if you're making a bow tie. Take the long side, put it over it. You fold it like a butterfly. Then you take this and you're going to squeeze it and do this little hole right here.
Come on, Brandon.
feed it through slowly until you feel a loop. When you get the loop, you pull the loops off or tighten, single off or fasten. And then when you feel it even or you feel like you got the sound that you want, you should have a bowtie.
Voila, very impressive. Thank you for that demonstration. Welcome back to Queen of Chronicles Talk, and I'm still here with the man, Mr. Bowtie. So listen, I hope you enjoyed that little bowtie tutorial. Now y'all know how to tie y'all bows. There is no excuse. So Antonio, is it easier though to tie a bowtie as opposed to the longer tie?
That's a very interesting question. The tie, if I'm honest, is very more easier to tie because, you know, just one loop pretty much, but they do have several different knots. Mm-hmm. But a bow tie is easy compared, it's easy, it depends on if you want to change your mindset pretty much. You know, it's, okay. It's different to require you to do different things.
Yeah.
So whether you know or not, tying a bow tie is the exact same method of tying your shoes.
Okay.
Same exact method.
Yeah.
So it's easy to tie your shoes, right?
Right.
The only issue is somebody is used to tying their shoes up here.
Okay. Yeah. That's true. Yeah.
It has funny ears and then it has the finger string. So
yeah.
Same concept. Not.
Nice.
So I would say the tie is easier, but you know, once you know the bow tie, you know, it's easy.
The mechanics are still the same, but it's what it sounds like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's still a knot, you know. So
Okay.
Yeah.
So I was looking at your page. I was perusing your page. I just wanted to see what kind of products you offer. Do you design your own bow ties?
I design all my bow ties. Mm-hmm. Every single fabric that's on my website or my Instagram, Facebook, however via social media you follow me.
Mm-hmm.
I design every last single product and fabric. I believe there's 232 different designs on my website.
Yes.
I design all one of them.
Okay. Yeah, that's nice. You have you have an eye for fashion. So that's what makes a difference. And it seems to set you apart from the regular other bow tie companies. So congratulations on that.
Yeah, that's what keeps me in business. I think that's what helped me have one up because most bow tie companies, they either offer plaid or plain solid, you know, or some fabric. But with my company, you can literally send me your company logo and I can make you a bow tie with the company logo. If you send me your face, I can make a bow tie with your face on it. Anything you want.
Wow. Okay. So listen, I got to congratulate you on, I just learned about a new collaboration. This is amazing because I just attended an event at Blue Smoke Cigar Lounge and I hear that you and that company have collaborated. That is amazing.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah. Shout out to my brother, Bush. Samaj Bush and my brother Jamel Jay, the owners of Blue Smoke Cigar Lounge.
Mm-hmm.
So what ended up happening was, like, I had cigars for like 2 years, and at Black Smoke Miami, which is a cigar festival we have in Miami.
Yes.
I launched a new cigar called a Hawk and Odin, which is named after my grandfather Odin Sheriff.
Oh, nice.
And, everybody was talking about, hey, Bowtie got some, you know, he got something going on over there. And Blue Smoke was the first one to jump on it. I think they were trying to beat their competitors in the Miami area because, you know, we got a lot of lounges. But it was like, man, we know Bowtie first. Like, we can call him. So, you know, we negotiated something, worked out a deal. So they got Brother Bowtie cigars in there. And I don't know, maybe by this year they might have all six of my cigars in there. Right now they only carry two of them.
Okay.
And we're on the third one right now.
No, but nice. We're going to claim that, Antonio. They're going to carry all six of your cigars. Let's put that in the universe.
Most definitely.
That's how it works. Collaboration, right? This is what Queen Up Chronicles Talk is about. We promote Black and minority-owned businesses. We're building a community, okay? So let's claim that your cigars are, all six of them, are in Blue Smoke cigars, okay?
Yeah.
So now, tell us, how did you make the transition from bow ties to cigars? And then to marry the two.
So how I made the transition was I started smoking cigars probably about 14 or 15 years ago.
Okay.
And often my groomsmen would order bow ties and then they would ask me, hey, man, I see on your social media you smoke cigars. Like, can you hook me up with some cigars?
Okay.
So I would reach out to some of the brand owners that I do know have cigars and try to negotiate a price for them. And I just wasn't establishing anything.
Okay.
So, like, it hit me one day, like,
right.
Like, you know, like, 8 out of 10 groomsmen going to ask you for cigars and talk to you about cigars. Right. Why you just going to start a cigar company?
It makes sense.
So, yeah, so I took a trip to the Dominican Republic and got connected with some people from Nicaragua and a couple of manufacturers. And, you know, I probably sampled a little over 70 cigars.
Oh, wow.
Try to figure out what blend that I want to use and how I want it to be.
Okay.
But I had to make sure that my cigars are different. So, right. Which they are.
Okay.
All my cigars are Nicaraguan. So what ended up happening was when I established my company, I thought it was like beneficial to add it to my company instead of doing new paperwork, hiring a new attorney, trying to get a new trademark, just keep it brothers and bow ties. And yeah, that's the new collaboration that I had to try to come up with, Brother Bowtie Cigars and Brother Bowtie. So in the future, you will be able to actually order, probably, I'm talking about in the near future, probably like within 2 or 3 weeks, you will actually be able to go on my website and not only order the bow ties, but you will be able to order the cigars off the website too. I just got a license on the state of Florida to actually sell my cigars online as well as mobile, as well as online in a lounge. So,
okay. Yeah. Oh man, congratulations. Fine. You're making some major moves. So listen, we have a Queen Up Chronicles talk exclusive we're going to share with the viewers. So go ahead and talk about the new collaboration, the newest, I should say.
The newest collaboration. So I actually got two that I'm working on. Right now I'm in negotiation with Amart, which is a black owned liquor company. So they have a brandy, they have a rum, they have a vodka, they have a whiskey. That's what I wanted to do was pair my cigars with a black owned liquor company.
Liquor company, okay.
And in Miami, I know there's three of them. Boat is another popular one, but they're vodka, but I'm like a whiskey and brandy drinker. So Amart has a nice taste in brandy and whiskey. So
okay.
You know, and the son, me and the son had smoked cigars several times throughout the last two years. So we established a relationship and so he told his dad, he's like, I think we're gonna need this for sure. Okay. Even if it's just for marketing, we're gonna need bow tie.
Yeah, so, nice.
Next one that I'm working on, I might be in top notch probably in the next 2 or 3 months.
Oh, nice. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. I might be in that. So we started negotiating and talking yesterday. So, you know.
No, but Antonio, you got to say you're going to be in there. You got to claim it. You know that?
Yeah, most definitely. Got to claim that.
So listen, tell the people how they can follow you, how they can connect with you, and most importantly, how they can purchase these cigars and the bow ties.
Definitely. So to purchase any of my products, you go to www.brothersbowties.com. Mm-hmm. And if you don't see nothing that you like, I always tell people, inbox me what you like and give me an idea. Challenge me because I want to bring your idea to life.
Okay.
It's my job to make your idea. If you can't find me on there on Facebook, you can find me at Brothers and Bowties or Brothers Bowties Cigars. On Instagram, you can find me at brothers_bowties or Dapper Brother Bowtie. That's my personal Instagram, Dapper Brother Bowtie.
Okay.
But it has all my business Instagram accounts on my page in the bio. Twitter, Brothers Bowtie. Email, brothersbowties@gmail. brothersbowties@yahoo. So pretty much Brother Bowtie's everything. If you Google it, you'll find me. So.
Across the board. Listen, Brother Bowtie is everywhere, okay? Oh man, thank you so much. You gave us a history lesson on the tie, right? We appreciate that. Then now you're giving us more information on how to tie the tie, okay? And then you also broke some breaking news right here on Queen Up Chronicles Talk, so I appreciate that. And I appreciate the time, so go ahead and have a wonderful day and also get your smoke on.
Of course you go. I got some more breaking news for you. I didn't want to leak it, but I think it's safe for me to leak it for you.
You're safe here.
Yeah, by the end of this year, we will have Brothers and Bowties suit line.
Oh, my God. Yes, you heard it right here on Queen Up Chronicles Talk. Brothers and Bowties suits. coming by the end of 2023. So thank you again for being here. Thank you for the great information, and I appreciate your time. This is Queen of Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West. Stay tuned for more episodes.